I actually got to a point, I was like, you know, I need to stop thinking that, and I need to actually
start
do
it.
And it just feels, I felt so mundane and boring. I was like, I'm another boring person, just like everyone else.
Yeah.
But
so I guess
I want to do something, actually.
Don't just dream in your sleep, it's just lazy.
I know.
That's the...
Who said that? Don't dream in sleep, it's just lazy.
It's yet another vlog, and honestly possibly the craziest one yet. And for once, I want to take time to just say thank you, because when I started doing these kind of vlogs just over a year ago, to think that I'd be actually interviewing Swim Deep on one is absolutely mind-blowing. But that is what we're doing tonight, because Swim Deep decided, for some reason, they're going to do 3 nights in a row in the Sun Pilot Lounge. Not one, not two, but 3 whole. It's a sick lineup. Tall Stories on the bill. We're going to be chatting to them. Swim Deep, the absolute B-Town legends. I'll be chatting to them very soon and just getting the lowdown of the antics, because when I actually vlogged Peace here, which somehow has never come out, that vlog, my camera got ripped out of my bag and broken. So God knows what is going to happen with Swim Deep tonight. It's going to be absolute carnage. I'm Connor from George's DJing, so it's a B-Town revival fest. You guys coming along. Shout out Josie on camera. Good time.
A very low light shout out to Patch and Vile on the Door, who has once again innovated running the door. First it was Hare and Hounds for, what show was that again? It was Mini Mansions, when Sugar Thief had to play on the actual floor. Which was great. Instead of crosses, we've got the little Swim Deep logo. I don't know if you were seeing the Eurovision thing, but
shout out. It wasn't actually my idea, it was Hers on the Stairs. So.
Shout out, Hers on the Stairs idea, yeah. That's Barry.
Did you see a Euro- the credits to you.
Yeah, did you see at Eurovision when there was a band that copied the logo?
Really?
Yeah, there was a band that sounded like 1975, but they had the Swim Deep logo on the...
It was crazy. Also, the lighting is sketchy, but I have gone for the Swim Deep merch. The pink long sleeve. You can confirm that. It's a smart business move to make your long sleeve tees £20 and the short sleeves £15. Who's going to not pay the £5 extra? That's why Swim Deep can afford day savers.
It is my absolute pleasure to say that joining me right now in probably the most B-Town location ever, outside New Snobs, is B-Town legends Swim Deep. How are you all doing this fine afternoon?
Yeah, good, thanks. It's a nice day.
I guess for you guys being actually a massive band around the UK and the world, you didn't actually really fully like in spirit leave Birmingham, because you're doing 3 nights here at the Sunflower Lounge now in a row, so clearly you've still got like a deep affinity with the city.
I think it's because like we're not even all from here anymore, but the same energy that we got when we were kind of like found here still lives on in what we do and like what we're trying to oh, it's my mum.
No. It's actually your mum driving a massive truck or something.
She would be getting beeped at, to be fair. What was I saying? Yeah, in this, it just still kind of very much in our mind.
Yeah.
Foundation.
It's very, I feel like a product of this thing.
Yeah. Product of your surroundings.
Poetic.
But I mean, the new album Emerald Classics, which is a great name, and it comes from a Birmingham pub, doesn't it? Yeah. Quite nearby.
It's like a pub where I pretty much grew up. I was saying to Oz the other day, well, I was saying to everyone, I think. It's like I've done literally everything in my life there, like my first bite, my first drink, my first
We can censor anything out in post-production if you want to say it, but...
Nah, I wouldn't say it. My nan will probably watch it, but my nan probably... So like literally everything, like family parties there, funeral, like everything I've done was pretty much grew up there. So it's like close. Quite close.
I've got to give a shout out to the Hare and Hounds as well, because I actually grew up in King's Heath, and I'm not sure if you guys actually played there or...
Yeah. We have played there, yeah.
It was your first Swim Deep show, yeah. We played there a couple of times. great venue. So glad it's not being shut down.
Yeah, absolutely, because the Flapper's kind of under threat, and I feel the independent venues, we love Spoons. It's good for actually getting drinks, but some of the personality maybe isn't always there. And I don't know if...
Carpets are good.
Carpets. Don't know if you could do a gig in Spoons.
Yeah, it's a shame, actually.
They don't play music in Spoons either, do they?
There's one Spoons in the world that plays music.
There's one in Redditch which has got a huge dance floor. I don't know if you've seen that. There's like a disco ball in the middle. So
there's music in there.
I think so. It's weird music.
The whole thing why Wetherspoons drinks are so cheap is so they is because they don't pay for the licensing to play music. They don't pay to play sports on TV. That's how they keep all their costs so low.
It's just a big lounge, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh no, they keep costs down because they see through the EU illusion. You know, they just don't pay the Brexit. You know, they're going to give us cheaper alternatives to what is it, Jaeger. But anyway, the new song to feel good on a note of Brexit, it's kind of really beautiful gospel, I guess, gospel-y and almost the streetsy style anthem. And it's a bit of a change of direction in you. But I was thinking, actually, people may be surprised, but judging by how you went from more kind of upbeat indie in Where the Heavens Are We to Mothers, it's actually kind of in the blood of Swim Deep to actually change your sound.
Yeah, I feel like everything we've done as a band has always been a reaction to the last thing we do. And I rate that in musicians and out of bands that do that. I don't like it when people stay the same. Like people, you know, if people moan about change, they can still listen to our early stuff, you know, or the second album stuff, or our third. Do you know what I mean? We're always going to change because it's just we're changing as humans anyway. Yeah. Blah blah blah. Yeah. But I think so it's nice the fact that we can come back with new music and actually no one knows what we're going to do, so we can kind of do anything.
And it's like you said on Twitter, I think it's the same, is it a Casio keyboard you use for the synths or something? Yeah. So it's not like you're, even if bands can, open quote, betray their roots, it's not like you're doing anything that's selling out or different.
We're not using like banjos or...
We're not doing Coldplay.
I wouldn't mind.
I quite like Coldplay, to be fair. Woo! Woo! I see a film made about you, stadium gigs.
I like that film.
Yeah, it's good, it's good.
I love the line that you've got in there, which is using the same day saver for a whole week. Because that language in itself is so kind of coded in what it is to be from Birmingham. Because I think a day saver, well, it's on the buses obviously, and other people from other cities will call it something else. But it's that, you know, feeling of, oh shit, can I even afford £4 for the bus today?
Yeah, Cav actually said something once. He was like, you could be the richest person in the world, but you never have bus change. And I quite...
Yeah, never have money to get.
You use contactless now, so... Brave new world.
Yeah, you actually on the 60 from my mum's, you can plug your phone in the back of a seat.
Yeah, those diamond, not like platinum buses.
Oh, platinum, yeah.
Yep, Kingsley, they've rolled the 50 fleet out in diamond now. But the next question, it's an important one, a contentious issue in Birmingham. Which is the greatest bus route in West Midlands buses?
The 11.
It's
biggest in Europe, isn't it?
It is. Yeah, some of my friends who are like bus spotters used to just.
It's the biggest like bus regional or city bus route.
Are we talking clockwise or anti-clockwise? What's your favourite?
Wait, where do we go? Clockwise, yeah.
Clockwise, that's yeah. Kings City to Kings Norton.
I spent more time on the 11 than I have in the Emerald, so.
Yeah. This album is called The 11.
What an album that'd be. It would show up about 2 years late then, probably. I love that phrase, and I think another thing about To Feel Good, it's kind of like, my interpretation of it at least, is being able to feel happy and trying to feel carefree in the face of a lot of adversity. And is it something you found kind of challenging to be a band that, I guess, have been perceived as like wildly successful when things aren't always going well? Right, you don't just wake up on a bed of like Breaking Bad bills.
It's interesting actually you got that from it, because I guess it's like the start of that, and it was like with me when I was 18 in Yardley, walking up to the job centre and feeling like I'd always felt that I wanted to do something and be special or whatever, but I actually got to a point I was like, do you know what? I need to stop thinking that and I need to actually
start
do it. And it just feels, I felt so mundane and boring. I was like, I'm another boring person, just like everyone else.
Yeah.
But
so I guess
I want to do something, actually.
Don't just dream in your sleep. It's just lazy.
I know.
That's the...
Who said that?
Someone on Twitter. Although I don't think they knew the song, did they?
Yeah.
Wait, what was that? It was someone famous.
So someone on Twitter just tweeted that quote and you were like, wait till you hear the song I've got for you.
Right,
I remember that.
And they were like, I'm onto something here.
Yeah.
I just think there's ways to make money. It's just changing. The ways to make money out of music is just different now. It's more accepted to do branded stuff and all that, because it's like people who say sellouts can fuck off, to be honest.
One of you was modelling for Burberry, so I'm guessing that wasn't too bad. Was that? Well, that was ages ago.
Wasn't me.
Wasn't it? That must be more fun than, I don't know, a coffee commercial. You could do it. I reckon you could do Fred Perry as well.
Very nice niche.
Maybe. Primark.
Biggest Primark in the world in Birmingham, and they say we don't have anything to be proud of.
I haven't actually been there.
You haven't been?
My mom's been there on a day trip, like a...
You can spend a day there, you can get a haircut there if you want.
Is yeah.
There's like
yeah,
a...
Genuinely, no joke.
Like a Disney... Like,
Disney cafe I've been in.
I need to be back, I might go tomorrow.
Yeah, Mickey Mouse shaped waffles, I'm sure you can sort of deal out. Get up to feel good, beaming out with the £5 t-shirts. But I guess moving from the Birmingham fashion scene, the big version, not the independent version, to the Birmingham music scene, and its state now, you guys clearly are kind of aware of it. You put Sugar Thief on yesterday, which is such a sick move because they're a great band and I think you guys are aware of them. What was B-Town like and how does that compare to like the scene now?
I feel like it was so before the actual music, that B-Town scene, it was just us going.
You can remember that B-Town scene, you weren't there.
Seems like a kind of weird dream thinking about it. Because not everyone had smartphones then, so there's not as many records.
Blackberries, we all had Blackberries.
BBM.
That was where it started, on the BBM. we all left London by the time, literally the second that St. Lo ever said B-Town on the radio, we'd all left. Because we were doing what we wanted to do by getting out of there.
Yeah.
And so it was a bit of a shame for the Birmingham music scene because it felt like it was over before it even started.
Yeah.
And then you got this aftermath. And it's really hard for bands to do aftermath.
Yeah, I feel like there was a bit of a fallout because it seems to have taken a few years for bands like Ivory Wave, Sugar Thief, Briscoes, etc.
They've got their own.
It took a lot longer than what I expected because I thought it would happen immediately.
Yeah.
It would be, you know, loads of bands. But it took a while. But like, I'm really glad there's loads of them now and they all hang out. They've got their own light scene and stuff.
Exactly.
It's tentatively titled Madlands, but I think like you guys have with B-Town, I just said that once and then an angry dad posted on Facebook it was like the worst name for a music scene he'd ever heard.
Yeah, yeah.
So I was like, oh, I feel like I'm personally attacked because people were tagging me and like...
Sugar Thief, they're like a shining light, I think. I really like them and they're gorgeous as well.
Yeah, beautiful men, Geordie especially, the flowing locks, we love them. And another band with a handsome lead singer, the 1975, who I believe you're still mates with because... good old Matty tweeted to feel good. And you spent a lot of time on tour with them in America, didn't you? So
yeah, no, they're like, you know, I respect them highly. I think we all do. But I think, you know, they're doing a great thing for music in general. I think people aspire to be songwriters now in music, just like he is in bands, not just making kind of like whatever tunes to make people, I don't know, it's just like sensitive songwriting that I'm really into.
Was there ever a bit of a bromance with Matty, do you think, Ozzy? Because I can, because I can show you a little bit of a picture. Here's the throwback.
I thought you were showing me the kiss one.
Oh, is there a kiss? Is there a kiss?
In the Lexington.
The Lexington.
Affectionate little.
Yeah, I might have got more famous off that than I ever did off any music. So.
On that bombshell, thank you so much from the. You guys are fucking legends, and you've inspired like a whole generation. So. I'm gonna go there and film all the fucking antics. I'll be in the pit. Peace broke my camera when I did that. They didn't, but their crowd did. That'd be a really good video and a clip. That'd be a clickbait title. I will end it on that. Connor from Jaws is DJing. How's DJing, Connor?
Stressful.
A little stressful. I'm sure I'm helping a lot with that. I heard Swim Deep played your birthday party when you were 16.
When I was 18.
18? That's fake news. I heard a rumour that you have a really sick music video coming out that I might be in that was directed by someone, which is a super secret, but what can you tell us about that?
All music videos are directed by someone, and this is one of them.
That is an exclusive. Connor from Jaws. Tool Stories, after a fantastic opening set at Swim Deep, how are you guys feeling? I mean, this is a bit of a post-A-level celebration for you, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, these two finished their exams literally today.
Literally. What were the subjects?
Biology, chemistry and maths, right?
Yeah. All on one day?
Oh no, it's just chemistry. That would be bad, yeah.
There's a reason why I dropped all of that shit long before. I was like maths dropping it the moment I finished that GCSE exam. So So I feel for you guys, man. What is it actually like being in a band trying to function and do gigs whilst having A-levels? Because it's so stressful, right?
It's not. But we finished the exam today, got the train back to home, and immediately started practicing for tonight. Because it's really hard, but you know, you make it work.
Yeah, trying to get the balance between them is obviously quite hard, but you know, do it as a hobby, so.
Yeah, I mean, to be honest, that show was a bit of a miracle because we probably practiced like twice recently.
Because like you guys, you've actually been around, you were telling me, for about a year and a half, but compared to say a Sugar Thief, you don't have the most massive profile. So was it a bit of a crazy thing for you guys to be on a bill like this?
Yeah, it was like pretty insane when Tom asked me. I was like, guys, yeah. Do we want to support Swim Deep?
Have you heard of Swim Deep?
I mean, like, we all knew how big a deal this was. You're a huge, like, obviously, yeah. Swim Deep fan. But we all knew when we'd been offered it. We were like, oh my God. And when we found out it was the day of the last exam, so we're thinking, we're not going to have a lot of time to get ready, but we were like, we've got to do it. You know, can't turn it down.
In terms of justifying your right to play, you literally bled for it. Because you can show Fran on the drums. How does that happen?
Do you know what? I often just like, the pedal hurts me sometimes, but I don't really think about it. And then in the last song, I was like, okay, I can feel quite a lot of pain right now.
Yeah.
And I looked down, like during Lost in Translation, I looked down and on the pedal, because obviously it's a white pedal, I just saw that like, that it was just blood soaked. And the worst thing is, it's their pedal, it's Swim Deep's pedal.
You bled on Swim Deep's pedal. That's the title of this YouTube video.
Yeah.
I bled on Swim Deep's pedal, not clickbait.
Horror story. No, they were really nice about it. So. Yeah, no. Who knows?
I noticed they followed you, and I guess that's sick for a new band to have, just as a bit of a boost.
I mean, it's Swim Deep.
Swim Deep. So cool. How would you describe the Sound of Tall Stories? Because I think when I heard your first song, I thought quite bassy. It reminded me a little bit of Joy Division in a way, but then Lost in Translation is the one that really sticks with me.
I don't know. I mean, we don't want to like pigeonhole ourselves, but as we've written, we've kind of gotten heavier. I think that would be fair to say. And the bass-led thing you said is like something we really like.
In terms of the scene, I've seen you, Fran, at loads of I've seen you at loads of other gigs. I remember, I think it was you saying to me, like, you're worried about being filmed during a stage invasion at one point, whether it was the Claws or...
No.
But you're really, like, part of the scene involved as a fan, so I guess being on the stage, it's sick as well.
Yeah, I mean, it's also quite intimidating because, especially, like, at the Sunny, you see so many amazing local bands here, like, all the time. I'm constantly seeing people like Sugar Thief or Violet, and when you have to perform, like, either in front of those people or in front of people that like them, it's quite intimidating.
Standard is high.
Yeah, it is. Like the scene here at the moment is really good.
Yeah, and I guess that just is testament to it. The Swim Deep have decided to come back here and slot themselves in. That B Town is recognising Madlands or whatever we call it now. Controversial, I know. Some angry dads are going to have a go. La la la, Ivory Wave. Every day it's starting to stress me out. This shit really.